In the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends. Good morning, today is Thursday, January 18, 2024. Today in history, 335 years ago today, the French Enlightenment thinker and jurist Montesquieu was born. His notable works include The Spirit of the Laws, Persian Letters, and The Causes of the Rise and Fall of Rome. Montesquieu, a prominent figure during the 18th century French Enlightenment, was also among the earliest scholars in modern Europe to systematically study ancient Eastern society and legal culture. Qingqiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qingqiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Malaysia proposes legislation to reform parliament. Recently, Malaysian Deputy Prime Minister Ahmad Zahid Hamidi proposed the creation of a new bill to ensure that the government remains in power until the parliament's term expiration after each election. He aims to prevent a recurrence of the one election, three prime ministers scenario, allowing the government to focus on effective governance. Following this, Minister Azalina, responsible for legal and institutional reform, announced that her department would thoroughly study the regular parliament law, seeking public input before presenting it to the cabinet. Under Malaysia's current system, the existing government can be ousted with the support of over half of the Congress members, leading to frequent attempts by opposition parties to sway members through various means to destabilize the government. Proponents argue that many countries worldwide employ regular parliaments and fixed electoral schedules, ensuring political and economic stability and thwarting attempts to undermine democratic systems. However, Malaysia's Islamic Party criticizes the proposal, deeming it absurd and contrary to the constitution and democracy. They assert that the Malaysian federal constitution allows for a change in government without an election, requiring the prime minister to resign upon losing support from over half of the parliament members. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. UK signs 10-year security deal with Ukraine. According to reports from Kyiv, British Prime Minister Sunak recently visited the Ukrainian capital and signed a bilateral security agreement with President Zelensky. The agreement, valid for at least 10 years until Ukraine joins NATO, ensures rapid and continuous defense support from the UK in the event of a Russian attack on Ukraine. Additionally, the UK announced a military assistance package of £2.5 billion in the next fiscal year, a £200 million increase from the previous 2 years, marking the largest funding commitment since the Russo-Ukrainian War. A significant portion, at least £200 million, will be allocated for the purchase and production of military drones, including surveillance, long-range strike, and maritime drones. The UK will also provide training for thousands of Ukrainian soldiers. Cumulatively, including this latest aid, the UK has contributed nearly £12 billion to Ukraine. The Russo-Ukrainian War, ongoing for nearly 2 years, has seen Ukraine relying on assistance from the United States and NATO against the Russian army. With internal political disputes hindering aid packages from the United States and the European Union, the UK's security commitments and reinforcement are crucial for Ukraine. The move aligns with the joint statement issued by the Group of Seven leaders last year, pledging concrete, bilateral, long-term security commitments to Ukraine, with the United Kingdom being the first to fulfill this promise. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Cambodia-South Korea trade hits $750 million in 2023. According to the Cambodia-China Times, the latest report from the General Administration of Customs of Cambodia reveals that in 2023, the bilateral trade volume between Cambodia and South Korea is estimated to reach $751 million. Cambodia primarily exports goods such as shoes, clothing, travel supplies, beverages, electronics, electrical appliances, rubber, and other agricultural products to South Korea. Meanwhile, imports from South Korea to Cambodia include automobiles, electrical appliances, kitchen supplies, beverages, pharmaceuticals, and plastic products. The authorities highlight that since the Cambodia-Korea Free Trade Agreement took effect on December 1, 2022, 92% of Cambodian products exported to South Korea have enjoyed zero export tariffs, significantly boosting bilateral trade volume. As per statistics from the General Administration of Customs of Cambodia, the country's international trade volume reached $46.8 billion in 2023, with China being Cambodia's largest trading partner. Cambodia's exports to China last year amounted to $1.478 billion, marking a 19.2% year-on-year increase. Meanwhile, imports from China were $10.7 billion, reflecting a 3.3% year-on-year increase. Laos collaborates with Chinese firms on remote sensing satellite technology. As reported by Vientiane Times, representatives from China Asia Pacific Mobile Communications Satellite Company, Limited, and the Deputy Minister of Technology and Communications of Laos have recently signed a satellite technology cooperation agreement. The agreement outlines the provision of services, such as mineral exploration, natural resource mapping, urban planning, and environmental management to both public and private entities in Laos. It stipulates reporting and discussing results and progress with relevant departments. Under this cooperation, China's Earth Survey satellite technology will be employed to detect mineral deposits in Laos. Advanced technology will conduct ground, underground, and aerial surveys, enhancing survey accuracy, reducing time, labor, and costs. Additionally, satellite images will be utilized for forest and farmland surveys, monitoring development project construction, improving mining operations, and aiding in activities such as surveying and mapping and urban management. Laos emphasizes that this collaboration aligns with the needs of the Ministry of Technology and Communications, contributing to talent cultivation in the field of science and technology. They also express plans to collaborate with regional and international institutions to facilitate the exchange of funds and personnel in scientific research and related fields. Now, here is some important safety information. FAA indefinitely grounds Boeing 737 MAX 9 aircraft. News from Washington reports that the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration has issued an indefinite grounding of Boeing 737 MAX 9 aircraft. The FAA will also intensify supervision over the aircraft's production line and supply chain. This decision follows an incident where a sealed door of an Alaska Airlines Boeing 737 MAX 9 detached during flight. Initial investigations revealed that the incident was caused by the loosening of spare door bolts. In response to the incident, seven passengers filed a class action lawsuit in a Washington state court, alleging physical injuries and mental trauma to 171 passengers and six crew members on board due to the Boeing passenger plane door falling off. They are seeking compensation from Boeing. The head of the Federal Aviation Administration has emphasized that the issue with this model is related to manufacturing rather than design flaws. He also pointed out long-standing production problems at Boeing, suggesting the need for a comprehensive review to identify potential flaws in the manufacturing and quality inspection processes. Russia warehouse fire causes over 20 billion rubles in losses. Recently, a fire broke out in a warehouse belonging to Russia's largest online sales platform, Wildberries, situated in the suburbs of St. Petersburg, as reported by Reuters. The fire affected an area of 70,000 square meters, with a collapse zone reaching 40 square meters. Nearly 300 firefighters, along with dozens of vehicles, a fire truck, and a helicopter, successfully extinguished the fire and prevented its spread. Authorities classified the complexity of the fire as the highest level 5, estimating potential damages close to 20 billion rubles. Fortunately, about 1,000 people were evacuated without any reported casualties. A preliminary investigation attributed the fire to an electrical fault. Wildberries invested 3 billion rubles in constructing the warehouse in 2021. However, the St. Petersburg City Construction Administration, responsible for overseeing construction, claimed it lacked information about the operations of the burned Wildberries warehouse, serving almost the entire city. The building had not officially opened for use, having received permits for construction and certification for meeting design document requirements only. The warehouse had not undergone a fire inspection. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Calibo City, Philippines, gears up for Adi-Adihan Festival celebration. As reported by Philippine Dragon Media Network, the Adihan Festival is set to take place in Calibo City, Philippines, from January 15 to 21. According to the Philippine Department of Tourism, the Adihan Festival stands out as the largest and most enthusiastic festival in the country held annually in January. Historically, the festival commemorates the Atis or Ida, one of the indigenous groups in the Philippines, characterized by dark skin and short hair, who were among the earliest settlers on the islands. The celebration recalls the 13th century when 10 chiefs from Borneo signed a land contract with the local king of the Philippines, expressing their peaceful immigration intentions. Additionally, the festival pays homage to the city's patron saint, the Holy Child. Participants in the parade don colorful costumes, embody warriors, and dance to the rhythm of vibrant drums, creating an infectious atmosphere that compels onlookers to join in the festivities. Financial newsletter. As reported by Global Financial News, crude oil futures have experienced a widespread decline in recent days. The main SC crude oil contract witnessed a drop of over 3%, while the primary low sulfur fuel oil and fuel contracts both recorded a nearly 2% decrease. WTI crude oil observed a 2% decrease, and Brent crude oil experienced a decline of 1.89%. That's all for today's Tsing Chau Morning News. Thank you for listening.